Boy George.
Exactly.
Good morning.
How are you?
Tired.
Yes,
tired. Now, of course, you were an icon, weren't you, of the 80s? You had your tresses and your dresses and your makeup. Why did you decide to reform? Because you reformed about 6 months ago, Culture Club.
Well, we didn't really decide as a band. It just kind of happened to us, really. We got a call from America, from VH1, and they asked us whether we'd do an unplugged session in New York.
VH1 is the MTV for slightly oldies.
Yeah, it's the sort of older crowd. And it was just came out of the blue, and we said, okay. So we sort of all met up, had lunch, to see if we could stand each other. And we got on great, and it was just really weird. It was weird deja vu, and it was one of those opportunities that, you know, you either take, or you know what I mean, or you sort of regret in a way that you didn't see what it was like.
And yet you remember why you split up, presumably.
Well, yeah, I mean, there were lots of reasons why we split up, but there's also lots of reasons why we should be back together again. I mean, we do actually really like each other, despite, you know, our history. I think, basically, you know, at the time, in the sort of mid-80s, you know, there was a lot of pressure on the band, and I think that it was a bit of an uncontrollable situation. I think we're all a bit older now, so we can all be a bit more rational about things.
And you had a relationship with the drummer, didn't you, John Morse?
Yes, always a bad idea. Never sleep with anyone in your band.
Which led to an acrimonious court case, of course. All that's resolved.
Oh, no, that was a different one.
Oh, that was a different one. Sorry, yes, it was. Anyway, all that's resolved with John, yes?
Oh, yeah, definitely. I mean, John, you know, has a child now and a girlfriend, so that's a bit weird, but... Yeah. I'm very friendly with the girlfriend, and the kid's gorgeous.
Tour, because you're touring with the Human League and ABC, two other big bands of the 80s.
Yeah, we just did a tour in America with ABC and Howard Jones, and yeah, it is a greatest hits tour, so it's all the old songs, with a few new things chucked in, but it's mainly a greatest hits tour.
Yeah, and you were saying that your mother was in one of your videos.
My mum was in the Do You Really Want to Hurt Me video, and she didn't realise how boring making videos was, and by the end of the day, she said, I never want to be in another video as long as I live.
There's no one like mums for bringing you down to work. Yeah. You think you lead an exotic, exciting life, I'm going to tell you, it's boring. Yes.
Well, yeah. She just realised that it was a lot of hard work, you know, because people think being in a band is like, oh, yeah, you sit around all day sort of getting photographed and eating grapes. Sure. And my mum sort of thought, God, this is really boring.
And it certainly wasn't it? Because you actually hit rock bottom after you...
Well, I always said that. The first video I ever did was in a courtroom, and I kind of started my career in a courtroom and sort of ended it in a courtroom, really. It came full circle.
But you've reinvented yourself, haven't you? I mean, you're not just going out on tour again, but you're a DJ now. You're at a column for The Express, isn't it, on a Sunday? Yeah. You're enjoying all that?
Yeah, I love it. I mean, I love the variety. It's really nice to be able to... I mean, when I got asked to write for The Express, I was like, yes! Because I got kicked out of school without any qualifications. I was like, me, a writer?
This DJ business, is that not a bit odd, though, spinning other people's records?
Well, I used to DJ when I was 17, so I've kind of gone full circle again. I mean, that's how I started.
Sorry, I was just in my earpiece. Yes. No, in my earpiece, the director said, spinning records,
totally spinning records, that's what it is. You got the right term. You did it right.
There you are. Thank you very much. I'd just like to say that I am young and trendy. Yeah.
She's got it going on.
I know nothing. But you're in great demand, aren't you, in Europe and everywhere?
Yeah, I mean, I do most of my DJing work in the north of England. Mm. I'm in Liverpool tonight, and I go all over the place. But it's brilliant. It's really good.
Mm. Excellent. Well, wish you well. When's the tour start?
It starts sometime in about December 16th, I think, or maybe a bit earlier. I don't know.
Well, never mind.
He's already got that nice pillow puffed up. You know, those lovely sort of pillows that you have on airlines.
Those who want to know will find out, won't they?
Yes, well, it's in the papers.
Yeah, yeah. Sure.
Look in the papers. Thank you very much for coming
Cheers,
in.
Thank you.
And good luck.
Always wear a short skirt.
Can you see yourself in any of those fashions, George? The hat was good. We liked the hat at the end. Do you remember the big giant hat?
Well, this is Philip Tracy.
Right.
He makes
like
a lot of
that.
The hats for all the sort of shows
does.
And stuff. Yeah.
Listen, Hilary, thanks for being out there for us, and we'll talk
Lorraine.
To you very soon. Okay.
Okay. Bye, George. Bye, Lorraine.
Because you know each other. Because of course you're in all that sex. You do DJing at these show parties and all that.
Well, I do a lot of the music for the Milan shows for Versace. Like the catwalk shows, and I'm always bumping into Hilary everywhere.
It must be great fun, and it's completely bonkers, because we've had a sneak preview of her life. We followed around with a camera, and it's mental.
It is. The fashion shows can be very bitchy, though. You know, people get very paranoid there and get front row seats, and
get
lots of dirty looks from people and stuff.
But you can't wear hats like that. If you're sitting watching, nobody will be able to see the clothes.
I actually wore a hat like this at a show in Milan and ended up getting on all the front pages of the newspapers because nobody could see. So the designer was over the moon. They loved it.
Ah, because of course, because that's what it's all about, isn't it? They want to get the stuff in the papers.
A lot of the time you get asked to go to fashion shows and they actually pay you to go.
Really?
Just to sit there and look pretty.
cool. And you do that beautifully. Nobody could do it better. It's great. Are you enjoying it? Are you enjoying it better second time round?
Yeah, I mean, America was great fun. We did 21 cities in 30 days, which was hard work.
Sure.
But it was a laugh because it was a real return to form with like really good crowds and stuff, and it was just a great vibe.
And is this with ABC and also
in America? We were with the Humour League and Howard Jones, right. And in England we start on December the 2nd in Dublin,
right,
and then go right through to Christmas. Just added another date at Wembley, which we're really happy about.
Oh, great. I'm going to come to that then. That'll be brilliant. We can wallow in nostalgia.
I'll get you some tickets.
Bless you.
Don't worry.
Pay me to come. I'd be paying you to come with a badge. And I think that's fabulous. It really is. But although, you know, it all sort of was wonderful in the 80s, you've never really been away because you've been DJing and you wrote that wonderful book. That was honest.
I've continued to work, you know, and the other guys in the band have continued doing other things as well. Mm. They've all been involved in music, but more on the sort of underground level. So we've all kind of kept at it.
And do you fight now? Do you still fight as much as you did?
Different sort of fighting. I mean,
yeah,
a lot of bitching.
Fighting?
Well, what tends to happen in the band is that, you know, like I'll go off with Mikey and bitch about John and vice versa. It's all very kind of innocent now.
Yeah, it's fine. It's not as kind of nasty.
We haven't got the energy anymore. We're too old.
No, that's right, exactly. And you've been there and you've done that, so you have. You know, I was talking about your book that you wrote.
Yes.
And I was reading somewhere that there was plans to turn that into a movie.
Yeah, it's happening at the moment.
Now, are you going to play you?
No.
Who's going to play you?
At the moment, it's probably going to be someone unknown.
Right.
We're looking at a couple of people. We've actually been doing it this week. We've been looking at showreels and stuff and different actors.
Who do you want to play you? Who would you like to play you if you could?
I think I want someone unknown.
Do
some
you?
Like young kind of British actor. I mean, the cast hopefully is going to be very, very British.
Right.
Julie Walters might be playing my mum, which is really exciting.
Oh, that would be great.
Because I think she's not only a great actress, but a really lovely person as well.
And she'd be very good at that.
Yeah, she'd be great as my mum.
Are you going to have something to do with this, though? Are you going to actually, because you're saying you're looking at tapes and things, are you going to be very...
Well, you know, I'm sort of involved, but, you know, trying not to interfere too much.
Impossible.
In fact, the people that are making the movie are actually watching this morning, so I've got to be careful what I say. Right.
So you don't want Ewan McGregor or Leonardo DiCaprio to play Bond?
Well, whoever plays me has got to be 15 to 27, so they've got to look good in a school uniform. And
Leonardo in a school uniform would be okay.
Leonardo doesn't look anything like me. He's too...
In a certain light.
Nah.
No, he's too babyish looking.
It's got to be someone British. He's American.
That's
British
true.
Film.
That's true. Well, Ewan McGregor could do it.
Yeah, he would be good, but I think he's too obvious.
Right, yes. I know what you mean. That's in trouble.
I think it'd be nice to get someone who's...
Somebody totally unknown.
Yeah, somebody unknown who's
fresh
a great actor.
Drama school. And this could be... That would be great.
And sort of, you know, get the surrounding cast to be kind of famous people.
Could we put all your life on the screen, though?
Well, it's always going to be a kind of shortened version. I mean, you know, it's not going to be everything. Otherwise, it'd be a 5-10-hour film.
Indeed. A very, very long, that's for sure. And like we're saying, back now, you've got a new single. In fact, I'd love to hear a wee bit of that. Have we got a bit of the new single? We have. Can we hear that? Oh,
Christmas already.
we're just having a look. That's the new single that's out what now?
It's out next 19th.
It's very good.
Thank you.
Yeah, it really is. It's really, you're really back with a bang. That's for sure. Anything that you would have done differently? I mean, there's the obvious things that you would have done, but anything that you've learned from that you're not doing now?
Oh, God.
I know that's a dangerous question, but you know what I mean?
I think this time round it's a bit easier because we've all learned to say no.
Right, how do you mean no to...
Well, it would be very easy to kind of fall back into that trap, because, I mean, at the moment, because we've reformed, we're getting asked to go everywhere, and, you know, we're getting offers for hundreds and thousands of TV shows, and you just physically can't do it, so you learn to say, sorry.
Right.
You know, in the old days, we just did everything.
Sure.
In Flat magazine, you know, opening of a toilet, you know, everything. Whereas now, it's just like, no, I mean, I'm too old, I can't be dealing with it.
Really?
Yeah.
So you've got more control now?
I've got a remote-controlled Zimmer frame now.
Well, if you have, we all have as well. Do you know, it's so lovely to see you, it really is.
Thank you. And I saw you this morning, we both had no makeup
on.
Do you
know, we really frightened each other this morning when we came in together, from separate cars, I should say. But we did come in together and we sort of went...
Well, you had a limo.
A huge, huge limo, massive, with a jacuzzi in the back.
Actually, you look quite good with that, you slap on.
Do you think?
Yeah.
So did you.
I still recognised you.
Did you?
Yeah. I mean, you know, there's nothing worse than seeing somebody go, who are you?
is that such and such mother?
Yeah. I get that a lot. I get people saying, you know what you look like? You know, if I'm walking around without my face on, people ask me if I'm my brother and stuff like that.
Right. But you do, you scrub up very beautifully.
Oh, I do. I polish up lovely.
And I'm looking forward to seeing you in action. It'll be lovely. Yeah. Wallowing in nostalgia. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Lorraine.